Games keep on coming for the month of May, and even though majority of them are going to be single-player game, here is one which is a multiplayer game. This game is called Hood, Outlaws and Legends. This game is a complete multiplayer action-oriented game where you will be in a team of four, infiltrating a fort and trying to loot a treasure that is hidden somewhere in a vault. The game is pretty simple. You need to find the key, which is held by the sheriff, who is a very powerful knight. Then you find the vault and then take the chest to one of the extraction points and veil it to your side. But the fight is not over, because along with your team, there is another player team who will be hunting for the same exact chest, and they will try to stop you to take that chest away. And along with them are the AI enemies who will also try to kill you. So in the end, it is a complete deathmatch as you are trying to take the treasure away, and that's exactly what happens in this game. A complete big deathmatch with multiple respawns until one team wins the game. The first two stages of the game, that is taking the key and finding the vault, can be done in a few minutes. But the last stage, that is veiling the chest to your side, that takes around 15 minutes to sometimes even 20 minutes as the brawl keeps on happening, since veiling takes a hell long time. You can technically go all stealthy to start the match and avoid any detection and then get to the vault, but that rarely happens. Usually what people do is go run in and let everyone detect you, because it doesn't really matter, since you can easily kill these AI pretty quickly. There are some AI enemies who are harder to kill one-on-one, while there are some that are very easy. You can always try to distract an enemy while the other teammate of yours can assassinate them. However, the sheriff is someone you should not deal with. If he gets your attention, he starts walking towards you, like Mr. X from Resident Evil 2. But you can outrun him, although try to stay away from him, because if he gets too close, yeah, you're dead. Each team will have 4 different characters, and each of these characters have their own ability. 2 of these characters are brawlers or tanks, and basically used to brawl a lot more. One of them is called John, who uses a hammer, has a heavy and light attack, and can help open large metal doors, and also wail faster and take the chest to the extraction point faster. Similar to him is another character named Took, who has a flail type weapon, and his ability is to able to heal yourself and your entire team, and also mark enemies. The other two characters are assassins. One of them is Robin, who is an archer, and his ability is to shoot an explosive arrow which can take down the sheriff as well and put him to sleep for a long, long time. The other one is called Marianne, who is very much useful for close stealth attacks and has a crossbow in her hand which can shoot 3 arrows at maximum, and her ability is to go invisible. These characters are pretty great to play since they have different playstyles. If you become an assassin, you really need to either stay far away as an archer or be very close as an assassin, that is Marianne, and try to hide as much as you can to assassinate whoever you see. If you are brawlers, well, it's better to fight one-on-one. But the real issue here is balancing. Somehow a brawler and an assassin run at the exact same speed. You would expect that a brawler or a tank, like someone that big, would be running slower. But nope, that's not the case here. These guys are literally Usain Bolt. They run like crazy. This is a big disadvantage, since the assassin cannot take down a brawler that quickly, and an assassin is supposed to be quicker than a brawler in terms of movements. But that is not the case at all. Although a brawler will be a bit slower when he does heavy attacks, but still, there should be a balancing of some kind which is very much needed. Now, everyone in this game is able to assassinate someone from behind, but you need to be crouched. Of course, this is because the game has the idea of stealth, and that makes sense, but during the third phase, it's not stealthy anymore. If I'm standing behind some enemy and he doesn't know it yet, I should be able to assassinate him, but that is just not happening. You will have to crouch and then go for assassination, which takes away the momentum you came up with somehow. Even though the game tells you to try to be silent, well, that never works out because all hell breaks loose anyway. And you will have to be part of the deathmatch where all you do is to try to kill, die and revive. And because there's someone always hiding in the bushes or some close corner because of how the maps are designed, and unless and until you are ultimately focused, you will not be able to take down, and the whole process keeps on repeating. The good thing is that there are spawn points in this map, usually 3 spawn points, that can help you to spawn close by, and if the enemy has taken those spawn points from you, you can try to regain them so that now the spawn point for the enemy is at a point farther away, so that gives you a slight advantage. Each one of your characters will have a stamina bar as well, which will deplete faster if you do heavy attacks, or dodge a lot, or try to block it. Brawlers can only block, while assassins can dodge, which makes sense. So based on what character you're playing, you also need to understand what you're doing, and it will take time for you guys to try to understand these characters and also the map design to understand how to play and how to focus your attacks and where to focus them. Now if you talk about the matchmaking this game, well, that is sort of broken for the time being. It matches you with the players whose ranks are much higher than you. Now the reason why it's bad, because the enemy team will now have more experience with their characters and the map, and that becomes way harder for anyone like me who's playing the game for the very first time to play well and enjoy it that much, because the other team will know everything about the map as well as their characters. So the matchmaking should be based on skill basis or rank basis so that people can learn and grow as you play the game more. Now your team can choose any 4 characters, but you're not limited to that, because if you wanted, your team can have 4 same characters. For instance, a team can have 4 Johns or 4 Robins, but that can be proved to be a lot irritating. For example, in a match, if you have 4 Johns, those are 4 big brawlers, then it becomes almost impossible for the other team, which might have 2 assassins, to save themselves or kill the other team, because these 4 Johns will become just too overpowered. This is where the game needs to have some kind of rule. Like, you know how Overwatch has a rule where you can basically have 2 tanks and 2 attacks and 2 heals. Similarly, I think that this game should have a rule of having only 2 tanks and 2 assassins, which is the ideal way of playing this game. But this game does not allow that at the moment. You can have 4 tanks all the way, and that makes it super hard for the other team if they have 2 assassins. Even though you can manage to find a character that you like the most and learn that character and able to fight well, the server causes another issue. Joining a custom server causes so much problem. Many times, I wasn't able to join even though I accepted the invite, or the host kept on seeing a message that I'm joining the match even though I did not get any invite. Many times when we start the match, I had a black screen where I can only see the UI, and I had to kill myself once so that the black screen issue can go away. We have also been kicked out of the server randomly, and also the game has crashed multiple times. So these issues, which are technical issues, they still persist and they need to definitely be taken care of so that people can actually enjoy this game and do not forget about it. However, the best thing is how the world looks absolutely beautiful, and visually everything looks appealing. From character models to map design, they all look really well. The sound effects are also really, really satisfying to hear. The communication factor is the key in this game, otherwise it might get hard to play. You will have to keep an eye out, especially if you are an assassin, to help your team out and pick out every other enemy team so that they cannot reach your teammates. And if you are a brawler, you have to make sure that you brawl and you punch and you smash. They also need to add more content in the game in the near future, because there's nothing special other than, well, this. And sooner you will learn the map, and eventually everybody will know where Walt lies, and eventually everybody will know what to do, and it will quickly become very boring. This game looks good and has a great idea, but it needs to work a lot more, improve a lot more, and add or change a lot more things so that people can enjoy the game. So at the current state, I would not recommend you to buy this game, and maybe wait for a few months, and maybe then you can go on for this game if the game goes on a sale. Do not forget to subscribe to Gamer Connect to watch more awesome content every single week.